Most people don't even know this. You go into places like Dearborn, Michigan, you don't feel like you're in America anymore.
Right now we're heading towards the east side of Dearborn. You'll see the culture shift where you won't feel that you're in the United States any longer.
How long have you lived in Dearborn?
All my life.
Seriously, what happened to all the American businesses around here?
They come in to buy the strip mall. They move the previous owners out. They increase the rent dramatically. They force them out. They force people out.
And then they put similar
businesses,
but with a Arabic tone.
Yes.
You think a lot of people here voted for Obama?
Of course they did.
Yeah? Why? Why do you think they voted for Obama?
The entitlements, all the health care. Some of these guys come in and have up to four wives. When they file for the bridge cards, the EBT cards, they are bringing the other three as extended family members. When we're going grocery shopping, you see these young Arab ladies, girls, with their kids, getting out of Range Rovers, using their EBT bridge cards to pay for the groceries. I'm actually in the medical equipment business, so sometimes when they come in my office, they're in designer clothes, carrying Prada purses, pulling out their Medicaid cards for their health care. And knowing the addresses and knowing where they live, I don't understand how they're getting welfare assistance driving 60,000, 70,000 vehicles and living in 250,000, 350,000 homes.
Immigrants from the Middle East represent the fastest growing immigrant demographic in the United States. And over the past 3 years, the Obama administration has taken in more immigrants from the Middle East than Mexico and Central America combined. And it's about to get worse. 7 million Syrians have applied to come here to the United States as refugees. Imagine the strain on the welfare system. Today, 36% of Americans claim to earn less than $30,000 per year. But in the Muslim community, it's up to 45%. 5 or 6 years ago, was it anything close to where it is right now?
Absolutely not. The population is probably doubled in this area, in Dearborn Heights, as far as the Middle Eastern population.
Over the last 5, 6 years?
5, 6 years. I see more radicalization.
Yeah.
Arabs moving in.
Excuse me.
Like, they're coming here, but they don't want to mix in with Americans?
Right, they're not mixing in.
Yeah.
They're not learning the language.
Reuter Street? Do you know where Reuter Street is? You don't know where Reuter Street is? Thank you.
They're not really becoming Americanized. In the high school where you have a large Muslim population, they have to serve halal food. The non-Muslim, it's actually two menus, one for the non-Muslims and one for the Muslims.
So now, what's the impact on that?
That's an increased cost to the school systems.
You never see American flags?
Never.
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 Why is it that the Muslim community is not blending in with the rest of American society?
Because this is what they are being told in mosques across the United States, Dennis. And part of what they're teaching them in the mosque is do not assimilate with the Americans. They are your enemies.
One of the things that bothered me is that as I traveled through one street after the next, and I'm talking about many streets,
I did not see homes with an American flag waving outside. Is there any chance we have that Muslims will turn around and start to blend in?
No, there is no chance. We are seeing a reverse, actually, instead of them blending in, instead of assimilation.
If you would take somebody, like an old neighbor who used to live in Dearborn but moved away, and you were to drop them back into Dearborn, would they know where they were?
Not really. It's completely remade.
Hold on. So, what do you think the deal with that is?
The flag?
Yeah.
They've been here a long time. That's a statement too.
That flag's making a statement. Yeah. What is the statement?
That's an American.
Yeah.
This is
America.